Okay, hi everyone. My name is Artem, and today I'd like to tell you about uplift prediction and describe some new methods of the corresponding problem. So the goal of the uplift prediction is to estimate the causal impact of the treatment at the individual level. It has at least two spheres of using. For example, in digital advertising, treatment is usually an exposure to ads, and in personalized medicine, it can be a medication. In our case, in addition to basic features and answers, we also have an extra column of a treatment, and therefore. All customers in our data set can be divided into groups, treatment T and control C. And having such another assumption here is that our features must be independent of treatment. So having such a data set, our purpose is to predict the probability difference of two following probabilities. This one and this one, which is exactly an uplift. And the main difficulty here is that we always can to observe only one of the potential outcomes. For instance, the patient can't simultaneously take and not to take medication. Speaking about metrics, metrics is an important part in uplift prediction problem because they differ from basic classification metrics, as they based on ordering of the customers according to their uplift scores. Here we decided to use Kini coefficient or Q metric. For the first K individuals ordering by the uplift score, Q pi K is as follows. And here the R PK is a number of positive outcomes among the first K data points, and RK bar is the same value but having the random prediction. These two coefficients N, T, and C corresponds to numbers of customers in group T and C respectively among the first K. And the metric intuitively reflects how higher can be difference between two numbers of positive outcomes having our model and having the random one. To obtain the Q pi, one need to normalize Q pi K by the same value, but having the ideal ordering of the data points. Here you can see an example of the Kini curve, which is the blue one, and the curve according to the random prediction is green, and the red curve corresponds to ideal ordering of the data points. Now about the current methods of uplift prediction. First one, two-model approach, uses two separate probabilistic models. First one can be trained on group T and the second one on C. And we can just compute uplift as a difference of their predicted probabilities. But the main goal of the models here is to predict outcomes, but not exactly uplift. Using the revert label method, one can use basic classification models for the uplift prediction problem by creating the new label Z, which is looks like this. And for uplift prediction, we obtain the formula with only new label Z. Yes, only depends on only one variable Z. But all capacity of model is spent for direct uplift prediction without any conjectures of relation between treatment and outcome. We propose two new methods of this problem, which are based on different data representations. So dependent data representation, or DDR, is based on a classifier chains method. So at the beginning, we train a first classifier on a group C, and then use their predictions of this classifier as an extra feature for the second classifier, which can be trained on a group T. Yeah, so we then can uplift, obtain uplift as follows. And the second method, shared data representations, or SDR, is some kind of data augmentation for this task. So here you can see the modified data set, which allows us to learn related tasks. In our case, it's two groups, T and C, jointly and simultaneously with a single loss. So in this case, weights vector W looks like this, with adding treatment and control parts of weights. And at the inference stage, we compute uplift using the two different representations of customer features, if as if individual were in group T or C. So about the data set, we decided to use Hillstrom data set in our task, which contains results of email campaign from one internet-based retailer. So here, group T received an email featuring women's merchandise, and group C don't receive any email. We also do 50 stratified random train test splits and covered different cases with balanced and imbalanced groups T and C. So firstly, we compare two model methods and DDR, as second is like an extension of the first. And here you can see that on imbalanced cases, DDR significantly outperforms two model method. Then we compare reward label with SDR, as they have a similar nature of the learning. And again, in imbalanced cases, SDR looks like significantly better than reward label. So, to summarize, we propose two new approaches for the uplift prediction problem, which outperform the current ones on imbalanced cases. Thank you for your attention.